I'm trying to detach the liver and take it out. So first of all, I will cut through the falciform ligament. Cutting through the falciform ligament now. Then try to release some of the adhesions. This is the right colic flexure. Trying to release it from the visceral surface of the liver. Okay. And try to cut in the diaphragm. Cut the falciform ligament here with the triangular and coronary ligaments. This is the coronary ligaments. The liver is held in position by these ligaments. It is held in position by its relation of the visceral surface to other viscera, as well as to its connection to the inferior vena cava, as the hepatic veins arrive from the liver into an intrahepatic portion of the inferior vena cava. It's very difficult to mobilize. Here we have the left triangular ligament. I'm trying to cut it, okay? Now I can mobilize it a little. Now I'm trying to find the free border of the lesser omentum. This is the stomach, body of the stomach, giving rise to the pylorus. And here should be, yeah, I can feel the vessels and the bile duct here at the free border of the lesser omentum. I'll try to cut into them to remove the liver. Of course, I have to make sure that the inferior vena cava should also be cut, because there is an intrahepatic portion of inferior vena cava. Now I'm cutting into the lesser omentum. This is the site of the inferior vena cava. I'll try to cut it. Yeah, that's the inferior vena cava, has been cut. So here is the other part of the inferior vena cava, then below the liver. Trying to cut it again. Good. So, can see here we cut the inferior vena cava twice. This is on the diaphragmatic surface of the liver. The inferior vena cava has been cut, and this is more distally. The inferior vena cava has been cut as well. So you can see that the inferior vena cava has an intrahepatic course within the liver. This is the left triangular ligament. It was connected to the diaphragm. And here you can see the bare area of the liver between the two coronary ligaments. This is the region of the hilum of the liver, where the portal vein, the biggest structure, is gaining access into the liver. Now, after removal of the liver, You can see here, this is the inferior vena cava, which has been cut. And anteriorly, this is the site of the free border of the lesser omentum. This is the lesser omentum, which is attached to the lesser curvature of the stomach. And at the free border of the lesser omentum, there is the portal vein, which is the biggest structure, located most posteriorly. It is big. And anterior to it is the hepatic artery on the left side. And on the right side, this structure is the bile duct. So this is the triad, which is located in the free border of the lesser omentum. And in between this triad, where I'm and the inferior vena cava, I'm putting my little finger now. This is the site of the epiploic foramen. So posteriorly, the epiploic foramen is bound by the inferior vena cava, and anteriorly it is bound by this triad of structures: portal vein, hepatic artery, and the bile duct. This is the epiploic foramen again, and it gains access through it. You gain access to the lesser sac. So this is the region of the lesser sac behind the stomach. I can feel here the parts of the pancreas, which forms part of the bed of the stomach. Here, after removal of the liver, also you can see, after removal of the liver, you can see the kidney. This is the right kidney. Part of the kidney is related to the visceral surface of the liver, so as the suprarenal gland, which is not very clear, but this is the site of the kidney. These vessels on the inferior surface of the diaphragm, which you can see them here, this one or this one, these belong to the inferior phrenic vessels, branches of the abdominal aorta.